Well, this is the spindle. I'm playing around. I'm not playing. I'm working on the bearing adapters. Anyway, this is the outer piece. This is the outer one that goes on here. Okay. And that's to adapt the bearing. So the bearing fits nice. In the process, I came across, I found that there was a handful of them that did not want to fit on their slip fit. I mean, could have heated them up, put them on. Challenge with that is that once you do that, they stay stretched. And then it's a question of whether the outside stays the same diameter. So I use Loctite 680, which is good to like 7/1000ths gap. And obviously there's nowhere near that kind of gap there. You know, some are a hair looser, but yeah, see, that's just a little bit looser. But anyway, once they're on there, then I need them to fit the bearing. Okay, they'll be glued on, and I need the bearing to be able to go on there. Well, I found that, okay, so what I did for the inside one, I had this piece that I made when I was doing these things before, and basically I just slip it in there, clamp it in the three jaw, it tightens down, and then I can sand the inside and then just test fit it again and make sure that it's good to go. Okay. Okay, so how these were made, I did them out of a piece tube. I grabbed it where my fingers are with the jaw, and I turned the inner and outer IDs on the CNC lathe, the little one, and then I cut them off. Okay. So I don't have that ability once they're made. And I'm not exactly sure why some of them are off as far as they are. That one's just right, obviously, but some others, you know, maybe they got dropped, dinged, banged, I don't know. And it could be kind of like with the spindle, the tolerance is slightly different than the one I tested it to. Anyway, so I showed you how I came up with, how I was able to open the inside up, but then it's like, how do I grab the inside? For me, what those are, drum roll sanders, or a sanding roll or sleeve or whatever for a drum sander. So as it turns out, it must be like a 3/4. I took the sanding roll off, and it works beautiful. Just leave it chucked up in there, and then snug the rubber down, and then... Now, that's out of... That's not very concentric, but I'm just taking the outside down a tiny bit, and I'm doing it with sandpaper. Doing it with the sandpaper, I should be able to maintain even enough consistency. And actually, now that I'm thinking about it, I'll probably turn it down a little bit, because if you spin too fast, then every time it goes out, you can hop over, kind of thing, instead of being able to stay right on it. So. Throw the bearing across the room. Yeah. See, that one just doesn't like it. You know, and if it messes up the rubber to the point, I hardly ever use those drum sanders. I've had them for years. So I'd much rather have it for this than for that. Now, if concentricity was a bigger issue, it is an issue, but if I had more to remove, had to grab it harder, I certainly wouldn't be able to cut metal with this, with a tool. This is more like what's proper, an expanding arbor like this. I have some smaller ones, I just don't have anything close enough to the 3/8 or the 3/4, so I'll have to buy one. couple of them. In case I got to do this next time, because I just assume not have to do it on the rubber.